and welcome to Scale Talk, a series of short instructional videos from Rice-Ike Weighing Systems. In this video, we're going to take a look at the 680 Synergy Plus. Okay, so by default, the 680 Synergy Plus does come with standard Ethernet TCP/IP communications. Before we can use that, though, there's a little bit of configuration that needs to happen. So let's talk about how to set up the static IP address for our 680. We're going to go ahead and press our config switch to get into config, and we see config on the display. Now at this level, we're going to need to navigate over to our communications menu, so I'm going to use that print key to go over to the right until I see COM on the display. Then I'm going to use my GrossNet button to go down. I see serial on the display. At this level, I'm going to go to the right. I see USB followed by Ethernet. This is the menu I want. So I'm going to go ahead and use my GrossNet key to go down into that menu. The first option I see is the ability to view the MAC ID for the scale. We don't need to do anything with that. We'll go to the next step. We see DHCP. Let's use our GrossNet key to come down into this menu, and we see that by default, this parameter is turned on. We actually want to turn this parameter off. So I'll use my units or print to toggle that and press tear to accept those changes. It's important to turn off the DHCP because if you leave it on, it's going to be looking for some kind of a server to give it an IP address, but we want to assign one to it ourselves. When we hit tear, we'll advance to the next parameter, and we see this is called enabled. If I use my GrossNet key to come down into that menu, I see that this Ethernet port is by default disabled. It's off. So we do need to make sure that we turn this on or it's not going to work. So use my print key or units key to toggle that to on, and I'll press tear to accept the changes. The next parameter I see is my IP address, and this is where we're going to set that value. Use my GrossNet key to come down. By default, it's all zeros, 0.0.0.0. Now the recommendation for changing the IP address is going to be use the units key to cycle all the way to the very beginning of our IP address. So as I press units, you see that it cycles off to the side, and I end up with just my zero at the front. The next recommendation then is to clear out all of the information about this IP address. So I'm going to press my clear key, and I'm going to see it toggle back and forth as it gets rid of all of the zeros and the decimals in that IP address. And when I'm all done, what I'm going to see is this little cursor with the decimal that lets me know that I'm at the very end and there's nothing left. At this point, I can just key in whatever the IP address needs to be. As an example, let's key in the IP address of 10.10.6.80. So I just press those numbers, 10.10.6.80. Now at this point, it's very, very important that you do not press tear to accept your changes like we do in other portions of the menu. Pressing tear at this point would insert a space and it would basically ruin the setting. So what we want to do is press the zero key instead to simply leave the editing portion of this menu. Then I'm going to use my print key to go to the right, and I see the subnet. Now the subnet's an important parameter to have set up on the scale. So I press my down arrow, we find that by default, it's actually 255, 255, 2550. And I can use my units and print key to scroll from side to side to see the whole thing. So if I do my units key, I get all the way to the beginning. There's my 255.255.255.0. We see our line with our decimal that lets us know we're at the end. So I don't need to change anything here. Again, I won't hit tear. I'm just going to hit zero to leave that editing screen. And now I've made sure that I've got my static IP address and subnet mask are set. We're good to go from here. Just go ahead and hit menu to save and exit at this point.